Welcome to Fortune Tech Debate, where we debate the issues of the day in 2 minutes. Today we're discussing what else but Bitcoin, which has blown past the $10,000 price point. And when is this thing gonna crash?
It's gonna crash any second now.
All right, any second?
Yes, absolutely. So look at other things, other asset classes that had a huge run-up in price. You have housing. This has been faster than housing. You have the dot-com stocks. This has run up faster than the dot-com stocks did before the crash. This is overinflated, there's no underlying value, and it is headed for a big bust.
There has certainly been a huge run-up, but I'm gonna play the bull here and say, look, there is so much enthusiasm about this. You have hedge funds devoted strictly to cryptocurrency that have fired up in the past year, and you've got interest from so many different companies, like Fidelity has their own Bitcoin mining rig, and they keep talking about it. It's like, as soon as they start allowing people to trade Bitcoin, if that ever comes to pass, regulators allow it, you know, you're gonna have a flood of extra money entering this. And at that point, where is it gonna go? Where is the ceiling?
I think the fact that all these old world companies are piling onto this means it is a bubble. There is nothing more like bubble logic than everybody kind of saying me too once the price gets really high.
Well, not everybody's saying me too. I mean, we have Jamie Dimon, the head of JPMorgan Chase. He's been calling Bitcoin a fraud. This only seems to increase the enthusiasm of Bitcoiners who see Bitcoin as an alternative to centralized banking authorities.
Well, so that's the other thing. An alternative to centralized banking authority, you know, if a real crisis happens, say gold isn't worth anything, you're really going to want something that is more easily tradable than Bitcoin. With Bitcoin, you need the internet, you need the phone, you need a lot of infrastructure to make that work. Society has to be intact.
True. I mean, if an electromagnetic pulse went off, it might fry some of these systems. But at the same time, I mean, it provides a store of value. Who knows where that value is going to settle over time. But if you compare something like Bitcoin to gold, people call it digital gold, it's still only a fraction of the total world gold supply. This thing could keep going up.
Maybe, but you can hold gold, make jewelry out of it, and it's backed by the government.
Anyway, time is up. Come to fortune.com for more tech debate.